I do not tolerate laziness on the job. You must have beds made neatly by noon, the rooms cleaned thoroughly by 4 o'clock, and the dining room table set impeccably by 5:30, so that dinner may be served precisely at 6. Do I need to explain this to you yet again?
No, ma'am. I think I finally understand.
Finally! Here at Wilcox's Western Bed and Breakfast, we keep our guests well accommodated, and that means sticking to our schedule. I hope you're prepared for the demands of keeping this establishment in pristine condition.
Yes, ma'am. I'll be trying my hardest to keep up, ma'am.
I hope you will. Now, do you remember how to greet the guests?
I think so. Welcome to Wilcox Western Bed and Breakfast. The best place for a little taste of the wild, wild west in the tropics.
Not bad. I'll be keeping my eye on you. Any indication of incompetence and you'll be looking for employment elsewhere.
Oh dear. Yes, ma'am.
I'd be on my toes if I were you. I've seen more young girls go through this place than you can imagine. The old bag goes through 2 or 3 maids a season.
Goes through?
You know.
Oh dear. She murders them? What have I gotten myself into, Beatrice?
No, she gives them the axe.
Huh?
Not literally the axe, she just sends them away.
To where?
The unemployment line.
Oh dear, she fires them?
Either that or they quit. They can't handle the pressure.
Well, it's a good thing I have a charming presence and a sweet face. At least, that's what my trainer told me, down at Maids R Us, when I graduated their training program. She says I have what it takes to succeed in any bed and breakfast. Good service, she says, requires nothing more than a charming presence and a sweet face. And a plate piled high full of pancakes. Pancakes for the guests, that is.
Huh. Will she ever stay at this place? With all the running around we do, you'll need bandages for the blisters on your feet to go along with those pancakes. And to think I once had a charming presence and a sweet face, too.
Dear, what happened?
The old bag used some of her own charm to make this face turn sour.
Phew, that was quite a walk from the dock.
Oh, we must be nearly a mile inland. The sky is getting awfully dark. I thought for sure it started pouring rain before we made it.
Welcome to Wilcox's Western Bed and Breakfast, the best place for a little taste of the wild, wild west in the tropics.
Hello, we're here to check in. Christine and Freddie Franklin.
Oh, Christine! It's so wonderful to have you back.
Do you remember me?
No worries. See, the sweet face is gone. I'm Beatrice Guggenheimer. The cook.
Oh, Beatrice! I didn't even recognize you! How are you?
Fine, thanks. Your aunt said you'd be staying with us this week.
Yes, for the Nautic family reunion. And Freddie and I are on our honeymoon.
We were married just yesterday.
Is that so? How wonderful. Connie, can you get Mrs. Wilcox and let her know that her niece, Christine, has arrived?
I'll find your aunt right away.
Poor thing's gonna get eaten alive. Well, I have to get back to the kitchen and finish preparing the afternoon chef. That's snack in Western terms. Christine's aunt makes us talk like cow people to the guests. Stupid.
This place looks great. I couldn't imagine a Western-themed bed and breakfast in the Virgin Islands until I saw it with my own eyes.
Isn't it fun? I haven't been here in so long. It'll be so nice to see Aunt Gretchen again.
A family reunion isn't exactly the most romantic way to spend a honeymoon, but free is free.
Oh, this isn't much of a family reunion. It's only Aunt Gretchen that lives here. The only other family members that will be here are my cousins, Rachel and Stefan. They're all the left of the Nautic family, really. At least the parts we keep in touch with.
Howdy, partner!
I'm such a
little Christine!
My, how you've grown!
Why, you're a woman now.
Oh, Aunt Gretchen, you look great.
Thank you, dear. And this handsome young cowboy must be
Freddy, yes.
It's so nice to meet you, Aunt Gretchen. Christine has told me so much about you.
Oh, flattering, I hope.
Of course.
So, Freddy, what business are you in?
I want to be a detective.
Is that so?
Yes, but right now I'm the captain of the evening security shift at a shopping mall. I haven't been accepted to the police academy yet.
But he plans to apply soon. Freddy will be a big detective someday.
Well, I wish you the best of luck. And how's the wedding?
Lovely. It was exactly what I wanted. Just a small ceremony with Freddie and me on the flock of white doves.
I'm lucky she even let me invite the minister. Christine wanted a small, simple wedding.
And of course, little Freddie looked adorable in his little tuxedo. And maybe he just wanted to pinch his little cheeks.
How sweet.
I'm just glad we can make it out here for the honeymoon. It's so generous of you to let us stay here.
Yes, we really do appreciate it.
Nonsense! This is what family is for. It's like a honeymoon and a family reunion all wrapped up in one for you. And speaking of family, your cousin Rachel and her husband Robert arrived a few hours ago.
Oh, I haven't seen Rachel for years. Are you supposed to be here for the family reunion, the only guest this week?
Oh, no. This is our busy season. Wilcox's Western Bed and Breakfast is almost fully booked for the next several months.
Place looks beautiful. I haven't been here in so long.
And little Freddie just can't wait for his pancake. Yes, well, when your uncle died, I decided to renovate the main rooms and always have a housekeeper on staff to help me keep things tidy. I believe you met the new maid, Connie Carlson.
Yes, she has quite a charming presence.
And such a sweet face.
Yes, well, this is her first day on the job. Only been here a few hours. I'm not quite sure how long she's going to last. And of course, you remember Beatrice the cook.
We were just speaking. I didn't even recognize her.
Yes, I deserve credit for that.
Is the secret still here?
Of course.
Secret?
This whole place has a secret. But we're not telling it, are we, Aunt Gretchen?
Oh no, dear. We'll have to wait and see if you can find it on his own. That will be a fun little game now, won't it?
If there's one thing to learn about Aunt Gretchen, it's that she loves to play games.
We play a variety of games in the evening here. The guests simply adore it. And tomorrow evening is our weekly movie night. But enough chit-chat. The two of you must be exhausted from your trip here. Let me show you two lovebirds to your room, the hoedown honeymoon suite.
Who is that? That sweet old woman can't be the same nasty lady who hired me.
Oh, that's her, all right. I've been working at Wilcox's Western Bed and Breakfast for almost 2 decades, and Mrs. Wilcox always treats the guests like cream and the staff like mud pies. It's like working for two different women.
It's here.
You'll get used to it.
What on earth is that?
Well, it's not Halloween, so either she's finally here to save us from the evil Wilcox, or someone's escaping the boogeyman.
Welcome to Wilcox Western Bed and Breakfast, the best place for a little taste of the wild, wild west in the tropics. Can I help you, ma'am?
I have a reservation.
Name?
The Night Crusader.
Oh dear, there's no one listed under that name.
Better find Mrs. Wilcox. I have to get back to the kitchen. Stupid.
Miss Carlson, what are you doing leaving a guest standing at the check-in desk?
Sorry, ma'am. I was just coming to find you. I couldn't find this woman's name in the registry book.
You are not getting off to a very good start. How difficult is it to find someone's name and show her to her room?
Sorry, ma'am.
Well, now, ma'am, how may I help you?
Reservation for the Night Crusader?
Let me see here. No? No, Miss Crusader, here. When did you make the reservation?
About a month ago.
The only reservations I'm waiting on are for Miss Camp and a Miss Steele.
That's me, Steele. A month ago I was going by the name Steele. Warrior of Steele.
Oh, well I see. How nice. You have multiple personalities. You know what they say. Two is better than one. Miss Carlson, can you show Miss, Night Crusader to her room? The Wyoming room.
Yes, ma'am.
There's no way I'm going to suffer from the agony from next to the two of you. We'll see what Mrs. Wilcox has to say about this.
Go ahead and stay here if you like.
Mrs. Wilcox, I need to converse with you right away.
Well, now, ladies, what is it?
I cannot room next to these two barbarians. I refuse to be neighbor to any person who hunts animals.
Would you prefer we hunt humans?
I can sure think of a Yankee I'd like to see hanging above my mantle.
You disgust me. You just disgust me. And you disgust me, too.
Now, Miss Matthews, we go through this every year. You know I can't stop the guests from hunting.
Yeah, we got as much right to hunt as you got to throw those little needles back and forth. Hunting's why we came here.
We got a tip that the best squirrels in any territory of the good old U.S. of A. are found on this here island, Dimly Carl Jones.
That's right, Ronnie May. There's nothing like hunting squirrels.
Well, yes, of course. This island is home to many of nature's most useful resources that...
Squirrels, you say? Here? On an island?
Pretty darn shocking the squirrel population hasn't been controlled yet, ain't it?
But this is a tropical island you'll never find.
I know you don't worry about all the breeding and multiplying. But don't get too upset, man. We'll take care of this problem in no time.
And get some good squirrel meat in the meantime. We'd be killing two birds with one stone, or two squirrels for that matter. As long as there's some killing involved, I'll be happy.
And what?
I don't know, but I can assure you that it won't be good for you or your sister.
Miss Matthews, why don't you sit down and have a nice cup of tea while you knit? It's iced.
Maybe it'll help cool your hot Yankee temper.
And ladies, why don't you let me put your rifle in our locking cabinet? Miss Matthews might be able to knit more easily knowing your firearm is locked up.
We wouldn't want to do anything to get Miss Matthews upset now, would we?
There's nothing worse than a Yankee blowing her top.
And who knows, maybe, if we give her the chance, she can knit herself some clothes that
look so sweet. But I do believe that I have the right to dress the way I please. There's nothing wrong in showing a little in an effort to attract the opposite sex. I was a former Las Vegas showgirl, after all.
Miss Matthews retired from dancing to become a professional knitter. She is our nation's current knitting champion.
I can knit one from two faster than anyone in the country.
She's also the president of the animal rights organization, Mammals, Amphibians, and Reptiles, oh my. With all of these interests, I'm sure the three of you can find something to talk about over a nice glass of iced tea.
I bet with this blue box.
Well, give it a try. And if you feel like going hunting, just call me and I'll fetch your rifle from the cabinet.
On Gretchen, Christine wants to know if you have any extra towels.
Certainly, dear. Let me get Miss Carlson to bring you some.
Say, who is this cutie?
Freddie Franklin, and you are?
Lola Matthews, national women champion, former Las Vegas showgirl, originally from New York City. Please meet your acquaintance.
And I'm Christine, his wife.
Say, you're a knitting champion? Honey, she's practically a celebrity. Can I get your autograph?
Yes, well, it was nice meeting you, but Freddie and I need to get back to our room now, don't we, baby cakes?
Yes. Excuse us.
I dropped your pen, Mr. President.
Call me Frank.
If you insist, Freddy.
Freddy, I've been mad! What did I tell you about talking to strangers?
Is that Rod's problem?
I wonder.
You sure have a way of making enemies, don't you?
I'm not going to sit here and listen to the two of you berate me. I'm going to try to earn it. He's quiet.
That's one you ain't got with no class.
Last time I'm going to tell you to leave extra towels for the extra rope, Miss Carlson!
Mrs. Wilcox, this is the first time you've told me!
Don't get fresh with me, young lady, unless you want to start looking for another place to earn a paycheck!
Oh dear, yes ma'am!
Mrs. Wilcox?
Oh my, I didn't realize you two ladies were still out here!
Go along, Miss Carlson.
And take your time. Now, how are you two ladies enjoying the iced tea? It's delicious.
Now about our rifle.
Oh, don't worry, it's as safe as can be. You wouldn't want to go hunting now anyway. It looks like a tropical storm's about to hit.
Just call us when it's time for supper, then.
Checking in?
You must be Miss Nell Camp.
That would be me.
And you are?
They're a small mime troop I manage. We're just passing through the area on our way to our next gig. That's Minnie. That's Maddie. And that's Molly. Molly here is the one who suggested a short stay at this place.
Oh, good. I'm sure Mimes will keep the atmosphere here calm and quiet. Now, if sure you want four separate guest rooms, we have a family room that has four separate beds that should be spacious enough for the four of you.
We need our separate rooms, lady. I drive these kids from show to show, wash their costumes, and take 15% of their salaries. I don't room with them.
I see.
I think I would go crazy if I were to be cooped up in a room with Mimes. Yes! That's it. I am a fine talent, no?
Yes. Your rooms are ready and waiting for you. Miss Carlson will show you.
Come on, kids.
Mr. Marston!
edible. Talk about an overcooked biscuit. I hear a broken tooth on this thing.
Oh, what a shame.
Won't make mention of it in my review, though.
Oh, good.
I won't have enough room to write about the snack after discussing the small room, the lumpy bed, and the view from my window of the large trash bin.
Oh, my. Well, I'll send Miss Carlson in to see if she can spruce things up for you a little.
Ah, the afternoon shuck is out.
Starving, though.
Hello, dears. Did you rest well?
Yes, the chance to lie down is exactly what I need after a long flight.
These biscuits are delicious, Aunt Gretchen.
Simply heavenly.
Thank you, dears. I'll be sure to let Beatrice know you enjoyed them. Christine just arrived a few minutes ago.
Christine, I'm anxious to see her. I hear she's recently married.
Yes, her husband is a cute fellow. Let me see if I can find her. I'll be right back, Mr. March.
How do you do?
You look familiar.
Well, perhaps you've seen us perform.
We are stars of the stage.
We've been in over 45 original theater productions.
And always together.
And not to mention we're husband and wife.
Yes, we're partners on stage and in life, aren't we, darling?
Yes, Devon and Suzanne Lewison. I saw you together in the Elms of Passion.
One of my finest roles.
Mine as well.
I should hope not. I believe I refer to your performance as trite and overstated, and yours as self-indulgent.
Wait, did Aunt Gretchen call you Mr. March?
As in Joel March?
Yes.
The nastiest theater critic on the West Coast?
Correction, the former nastiest theater critic on the West Coast. I'm currently the nastiest hotel critic on the East Coast.
I remember hearing you no longer wrote for a Theater Monthly.
I now write for Hotel Weekly.
What happened? Readers tired of your bitterness, or was it just jealousy?
I take pride in bitterness, but jealousy over what?
Well, I can only assume one who writes with such contempt for actors is jealous of their artistic talents.
Just me, my imperial friend. I consider myself lucky to never have been mixed up with your crowded, overcomplicated, undereducated bohemians. Where did you even learn that nonsense to refer to as art?
We attended Juilliard for some time.
Oh, Juilliard? That's right. Never heard of it.
I'm not just gonna stand here and put up with this!
Remember, Carmen, say this motion from the stage. Practice your breathing exercises. Stefan!
Christine, you look wonderful!
Thank you. I'd like to introduce you to my husband, Freddie Franklin.
Pleasure. It's so nice to meet you. This is my wife, Suzanne.
I've enjoyed Freddie around bed breakfast.
Have you told me about the secret yet? What is this secret everyone keeps talking about?
I'll give you a little hinty hint, sweetie. It's found right here in this room.
This room?
Do you notice anything out of the ordinary?
Not really, but I'm not the most perceptive person.
I know, sugar face, but you try. Don't forget you were perceptive enough to notice you wanted to marry me.
Is that my little cousin Christine attached to that man?
Rachel, look at you! It's been years!
Stefan, Suzanne.
Looks like the family reunion has officially begun. Suzanne, how did you saw some food?
I don't believe you ever had a chance to meet my husband, Dr. Robert Shanklin.
Nice to meet you. And this is my husband, Freddie.
Wait, let me guess. Polish, no.
Would be my first guess as well.
My family is Ukrainian, actually.
Darn! I was so close. But they must be from Eastern Ukraine, am I correct?
How did you know?
Robert and Rachel are anthropologists specializing in human origins. They travel the world digging up human remains in remote villages.
How morbid!
Oh, hello. I didn't see you there.
Would you care to join us?
No. He was not seem to be in the best mood.
Don't mind him, he's just a bitter journalist. Now, Rachel, your mother was...
Ida, one of Gretchen's sisters.
And my mother was Agnes, one of Gretchen's four sisters. Four?
Yes, we don't exactly know what happened to the fourth sister, but Aunt Gretchen, Aunt Ida, Aunt Agnes, and my mother were all inseparable when they were alive. The three of us practically grew up together.
That's why these family reunions are always so much fun to get to. Reminisce. Ever since our mothers passed away, we haven't seen much of one another. We all kind of went our separate ways.
Has anyone seen
needle? I've heard of looking for a needle in a haystack, but at the bed and breakfast?
Silly, it's not a tiny sewing needle, it's a big needle for knitting. I've seen it misplaced and I can't find it anywhere.
Well, hello. Why don't you try looking for your needle in your room?
I'm sure you'll find it there.
Thanks for the advice.
Well, Robert and I should get back to the room and finish unpacking. Well, I'll catch up to you more later.
It was nice meeting you.
We should head back to our room.
We'll see you at supper, darling.
Well?
Well, what?
Your eyes look like they're going to burst out of your head every time this knitting needle is around.
Oh, no, I only have eyes for you.
I don't want to see you looking at it one more time, or I'll scream bloody murder!
What? I wasn't looking at her. She's not even here.
That wasn't me. It sounded like old Gretchen.
I'm Gretchen doesn't blow in the hallway!
What? Bring her in here.
She's not unconscious. She's dead.
What's all racket?
She heard a scream.
The old lady's dead.
Dead?
Dear.
No! No! If only I had been there in time. If only I were quicker. More efficient. Why was this innocent blood you spilled? Whoever did this, whoever is responsible for this gruesome world we live in, will pay!
Are you serious? That knife came from the kitchen. Someone must have taken it, but it wasn't there. Mrs. Wilcox was murdered with her own knife.
Oh, dear. This note was found on the floor by Mrs. Wilcox's body.
Let me see. It's written in this weird orange ink. There was an old lady named Gretchen. The thought of her kept me up wretched. I took a sharp knife and ended her life, but me you will never be catching.
Sounds like someone had an improv Gretchen.
That poem is kind of catchy, though.
What are we going to do about Gretchen? We can't just leave her in the middle of the living room floor.
Don't they normally put bodies on ice? We have ice in the kitchen.
Carla Jo can take her.
That's one good thing about us Michael sisters. We're each as strong as an ox.
Expedition in Bangladesh.
full eyes must be down to the store.
And you know there's no self-service on this island.
What are we going to do?
You look like some kind of witch doctor.
Can't you do some rain dance?
I believe you're referring to the rain dances of the Cherokee tribes or other indigenous North Americans. Rain dances are traditionally performed when rain is desired.
It's clearly already raining. We want it to stop.
And there's no rain stopping dance?
Not that I know of.
Freddy, this is your chance.
My chance? For what?
To solve your first murder case.
I'm not even enrolled in the police academy yet.
It's never too early to start playing detective.
Oh, sweetie pie, I'm so excited for you.
I don't even know where to begin.
Just use the skills you've learned in mall security.
I can't.
If you do a good job, I'll give you a gold star. And if you do an extra good job, I may even give you a lollipop.
Gee, do I get to pick the flavor?
This guy is going to figure out who murdered Mrs. Wilcox. He's a 9-year-old trapped in a 30-year-old's body.
Let him try.
Yes, what if we got to lose? We won't have any contact with the police until the storm is over.
I know he can do it. I know you can do it, Angel Pie.
All right, Freddy, start detecting.
So exciting! A real life murder mystery.
Connie and Beatrice, why don't you have a seat?
We're not allowed to do the job.
You must be hiring. Your boss is dead.
Get the point.
I suppose the first thing I should try to do is figure out how long Gretchen was murdered.
I think the knife in her back had something to do with it.
Good point. I think it's safe to surmise that Aunt Gretchen been stabbed to death.
Oh, Mama! Oh, my little detective! You're doing such a good job so far! I'm so proud!
You're a fool! You just established the obvious! I'm going to my room. Let me know when you solve the murder case.
That man seems to be in a permanent bedroom. I was wondering what offs him.
Dear, you shouldn't talk like that, especially considering the situation at hand.
Suppose my comment wasn't for taste.
Well, I can get back to the kitchen and finish preparing the, or start preparing the chicken we're going to have for supper. 6 o'clock, and I haven't even started cooking yet.
So, Freddy, who do you think is the murderer?
I don't know. Also, I'm new at this. Give me a minute.
I'd mosey on out here to say hello and warm up a bit. It's cold in that freezer and there's nothing to do in there. Not that it appears anyone's doing anything worthwhile out here. Connie! I thought I told you that sitting down here on the job is not allowed. Well, I suppose she can't hear me. That tends to be the case when you've been murdered. So, what are these folks talking about anyway? Did you guys hear them?
Yeah.
Well, what were they talking about? Yeah. I had the foggiest idea of murdering me. I was in the hallway walking from my room to this room when I felt a sharp pain in my back. I must have been stabbed from behind. Well, let's see if Freddy's ready to be a detective, shall we? He may be able to figure out who murdered me. Resume.
I still can't find my knitting needle. Lola, we have bigger mysteries to solve.
But I need my knitting needle. This murder has me all worked up, and the only thing that calms me down is knitting.
Say, Freddy, you haven't seen that knitting needle, have you?
Remember what I told you? I don't see looking at her eyes for free.
No, I haven't seen your needle.
Well, let me know if your big, strong hands come across it, will you?
Sure thing.
I'm sure your needle will turn up somewhere.
I hope so. What is that around your waist?
Oh, this. It's a yurigido from the Lagos clan in southwest Nigeria. It's an apron made of skin.
Skin? As in animal skin?
Yes. Lagos women traditionally wear a pigskin yurigido after they've been married. It's similar to our custom of wearing a wedding ring.
You cruel, evil human being!
Excuse me, why?
That skin came from an animal. A living, breathing pig?
Yes. Robert and I were married by the Lagos. The yurigido was a wedding gift.
Tell me not another word. I cannot bear to hear it. If you want to wear something around your waist, try knitting yourself a belt. No animals are killed during knitting.
you ask me, you know better than whoever murdered Mrs. Wilcox.
But only a pig was killed for Rachel's apron, not a person.
It's no different. Maybe one day you'll know how it feels to have your skin and bone and flesh ripped from your bones.
She seems to be in a bad mood as well.
Well, speaking of skin and flesh being peeled from dead bones, I can continue working on the chicken.
So much for the crop this week pride ourselves on. It figures I've only been gone for a few hours and already this place is going to shambles.
Come on, Rachel. We need a break from all this discussion about order.
I could sure stand to pick that while myself.
We could use a break too. A nice nap before supper could do us some good. It's been a stressful day.
What?
I thought you were going to try to figure out who murdered me.
Well, you're all going to rest, and so am I. Back to the freezer for me.
You haven't seen my husband, have you, darling?
No, ma'am.
We were supposed to rehearse for an audition we had tomorrow, but he left about 20 minutes ago and hasn't been back since.
I haven't seen him in here.
You don't suppose he's gone missing, do you?
Lola's missing. Knitting needle's missing. Maybe he's with that.
Oh, you're too much, darling. You have such a charming presence and sweet face. With wit like that, you don't need stitches.
Have you ever thought about going into show business?
I don't know. I'm not much suited for the stage.
Try Hollywood. The camera would love your face.
I'm not sure. It seems awful stressful to have to learn all those lies. I tend to freeze under pressure.
There you go again. You practically have me rolling. Connie, do you know which is the key to the cabinet?
Mrs. Wilcox keeps it over here. Why? We want a raffle bag.
What on earth are you running guns for? We're going hunting.
Hunting? In this terrible storm.
Of course! The rain makes all the squirrels hide in the trees.
The trees are practically stuffed full of squirrels in storms like this.
Squirrels? And on an island, you say? And you're going to go outside in this terrible weather?
Heavens knows. You Yankees don't know the first thing about hunting. Did you hear that, sister?
I sure did, sister. Honey, we ain't going outside to hunt.
We don't want to get all soggy.
I'm confused, though.
We're going to open our window, fire our rifle into the trees, and watch the squirrels fall to the ground.
And then scoop up their dead little bodies when the storm stops.
What a delightful thought. I still don't think it's a good idea to shoot a gun indoors.
We'll aim the rifle outside, not inside. Don't worry.
Hey, the cabin's empty.
Where's our rifle?
I don't know. It's gone.
Are you sure this is Wilcox for the good day?
I saw her with my own two eyes.
And my eyes, too.
Somebody must have taken it.
This is a violation of the Second Amendment of the Constitution of the United States of America. Someone has been tampering with my right to bear arms. We've got a thief here.
Lola, isn't it? What if the same person who stole your rifle was the same person who murdered Mrs. Wilcox?
Oh, then we'd have a murderer and thief. Or a thiever and murderer.
Lola's knitting needle's missing too. Maybe the same person who stole both the needle and the rifle and the knife that was used to murder Mrs. Wilcox.
Did you say there's a thief in the house?
There sure is, though. Say, what do you call that? Yeah, anyway.
Get up.
Costumes you're wearing.
I don't wear costumes. This is my Knight Crusader uniform. Right now, I'm the Knight Crusader.
What do you mean, right now? Are you other people at other times?
I'm a whole bunch of different people.
Is one of them a murderer?
Or a thief?
No, I'm nothing of the sort. A true hero will never murder a silver anyone. Well, anyone who isn't a villain.
Then why do you wear that uniform?
I'm a devout follower of graphic novels.
I hear words coming out of those lips, but I don't understand what they're saying.
In other words, I like to read comic books, and I strive to live my favorite characters.
And right now, you're living as the Matt Crusade.
You hit the nail on the head.
I didn't hit nothing! And don't you go accusing me of violence.
Oh dear, it's just an expression.
Well, this gal better watch what she's expressing. Because it sounded to me like an accusation.
I do believe you were the one who accused me of being a thief, which is impossible. I am a Knight Crusader,
the Night Crusader does not steal. She fights injustice, successfully hides her identity, and still manages to maintain a relationship with the cutest guy in town.
Hey, Night Crusader, maybe you could help us find the person who stole our rifle.
That's an injustice that needs fighting.
I'll do my best, ladies.
And I better go back to my room and wait for Stefan.
Whatever you say, pal.
Come on, Night Crusader. Out of our way, Miles.
Those three are in a hurry.
They're on a mission to fight injustice.
Well, we're on a mission too.
What type of mission would that be?
A mission to fill our bellies. I got a troop of hungry minds here. And that one's thirsty.
Oh dear. Supper should have been done by now. But with all the excitement for Mrs. Wilcox's murder, we seem to be a bit behind schedule.
All right, but if supper won't be ready for a while, couldn't we at least get some snacks? I get awfully hungry watching these mice pretend to eat.
That corn on the cob does look good.
Hello, all. I just came to see if there are any good books in here. All I've got are my field notebooks, and I can't concentrate on work right now.
I know what you mean.
What are they doing?
They must be reading.
Reading anything good? I love a good romance novel. Ooh, horror. Not my cup of tea. How can you be reading a murder mystery at a time like this?
Maybe she thinks it'll help her solve who murdered Mrs. Wilcox.
A romance novel it is for me, too.
Beatrice says supper won't be ready for another half hour. I made you some cheese and crackers to tide you over. It's not exactly an authentic Western snack, but it's all I know how to do in the kitchen.
Thanks. Come on, kids.
Can I get you anything, Dr. Shankford?
Oh, no, thank you, dear. I'm just going to sit here and read until supper today.
I'll meet you here.
I don't even know what I'm looking for.
Just search around.
Christine?
Oh, Rachel, you're out here.
Yes, just doing a little reading. I thought you and Freddie went to your room to take a nap.
Chris.
We got back to the room, and I decided I just couldn't rest. Not until I knew who murdered Aunt Gretchen.
Chrissy wants me to look for clues.
Yes, all the detectives look for clues.
What would a clue even look like?
Well...
I'm a victor. A victor.
giant trail of blood leading right to the body.
Where's Connie? It's her job to clean it up.
You mean the little maid? She hasn't been out here the whole time.
And where's your husband?
I don't know. I haven't seen him in the past half hour.
Oh my, the blood leads directly to the secret.
Yes, it does.
You keep talking about the secret. What is the secret?
I suppose I should tell you now. Behind this wall is a secret passage.
A secret passage?
Yes, it's sort of a funnel of glory that everyone who stays here eventually finds out about. It goes right to the back of the linen closet in the hallway.
That was so perceptive of you to notice that trail of blood.
I do love a highly perceptive man.
Thanks. Say, there's a note on the floor. You think whoever wrote the note slipped it through this hole right here in the painting?
Or? Maybe. It's written in that same orange ink. Rachel had to go. But who shot her, you'll never know.
Again, catchy.
Do you think whoever murdered Rachel is still inside the secret passage?
Maybe.
How do we even get the thing?
You just lit the latch on the side of the fireplace right here.
How is that possible with that fireplace?
It's not a real fireplace. The builder of this home had a great sense of humor and used to cover the door.
Hold it!
Well, I've certainly seen a lot of things in my day, but never anything as low down and vile as an affair of family reunion. Then again, I've never seen a murder at a family reunion, let alone two. Suzanne certainly looks like she wants to give her husband a piece of her mind. Shall we let her resume?
So this is where you've been! We've been losing the secret passage!
Well, no, not exactly. Connie and I just left there a few minutes ago.
Then where have you been for the past half hour?
That's easy. You was admiring hitting on me for a while.
Really?
You would stoop so low as to put your lips on the higher help and miss him?
Excuse me? How dare you? His lips have been nowhere near mine. I wouldn't give him the time of day.
She had a heck of a time getting him to leave.
What do you have to say for yourself?
I'm sorry? Spock came knocking on my door a little while ago, but I told him to get lost. I don't fool around with married men.
Ha! He was hitting on you? And you? And of course, you too! You are a pig!
Hey, what can I say? I just wanted a little, female attention.
Stefan never hit on me!
I hope I never get that desperate.
Carla Jo, look! It's our rifle!
The murderer must have stolen it from the cabinet and brought it in that passage.
Not to get in the middle of this whole love crime, heptadon, but does anybody else find it suspicious that, Connie and Stefan were found in the secret passage? With the firearm? What, with the trail of blood leading from it at all?
Trail of blood?
Rachel's been murdered. She was shot by someone in the secret passage.
Oh dear, we just went into the passage a few moments ago.
A likely story.
No, it's true. I was just leaving Carla Jo and Ron in May's room when I saw Connie asked if I could talk to her.
He said he needed help rehearsing a scene.
In a linen closet?
He said he wanted to go somewhere where no one would bother us.
You mean where no one would find you.
Well, guess what?
We found you. You two tiny creeps.
Calm down. That still doesn't explain how the two of you could be in the passage without seeing who else was in there.
We were in the hallway when the lights went out. We heard a loud bang, but couldn't see two witches in front of our faces. Someone rushed past us, but we couldn't see who it was.
I thought it was strange that someone else was in the linen closet. The two of you heard a gunshot and still felt the need to continue your rendezvous.
Yes, Stefan is a dog who won't even stop for murder.
I didn't know there was a gunshot. There's been a racket in this place all night. I thought it was just another crack of thunder.
Then who was leaving the passage as you entered? Someone's not telling the truth.
That's an easy accomplishment for an actor.
Or an actress.
Or anyone. Clearly somebody here is pretending to be someone he or she or not. Stefan and I are the only ones here with acting ability.
We're not accomplishing anything by standing around accusing each other. Most of us entered this room by coming through
through the hallway after we heard the gunshot. Did anyone see anything?
How could we? It was pitch black.
Two murders and 16 suspects?
Oh dear, I'm scared.
I don't feel safe anymore.
You're the one holding the gun. You should feel safer than the rest of us.
Good thinking, Molly. Maybe we should lock the rifle back up. If it's locked up, we'll offer more ease.
Well, I wouldn't be too sure of that. Aunt Gretchen was murdered with the knife.
I sure was.
The murderer already stole the gun from the cabinet once. Who says it won't happen again?
Good point. Then maybe we should leave the evidence
in the hands of the detective!
Any idea what we should do? Anybody?
You're the one playing the detective.
Oh, right. Then I think you should all return to your rooms and lock your doors.
They're hungry.
It is well past some time according to the brochure.
I'll continue cooking then.
Wait, it's not safe out there. Suppose someone tries to hurt you.
Or suppose you try to hurt someone.
I'll stay with her.
Connie and Beatrice can work in the kitchen. Christine and I will stay up here and continue to look for clues.
Oh, Freddy, you're so adorable when you get authoritative.
What are we going to do with Rachel? We can't just leave her on the floor.
We'll take care of that. In the freezer you go with Miss Wilcox.
I better get back to the freezer before Charlotte Joy and they get there and notice I'm missing. That would be quite a shock.
Where are you going to look for clues?
I have no idea.
I know. Whoever was in the passage had to know that it existed in the first place.
Who here would know about the passage?
Those of us who work here know about it, and the passage is used during the evening games of hide and seek. So anyone of the guests who have stayed here before know about it.
Beatrice, which guests have stayed here before?
Lola stays here every year. Suzanne and Stefan have been here a few times over the years. Robert came with Rachel every now and then. And the only guests I've never seen here before are Nell, the Mines, the woman dressed as the Night Crusader, and the Michael sisters, Andy.
So about half the guests are here for the first time.
I suppose, but I've been working here a long time, and I could have easily forgotten the face over the years. Any one of them could have stayed here in the past.
In other words, everyone is still a suspect.
I'm afraid so. Well, the chicken should be ready to come out of the oven. If I don't hurry with this meal, I'll have some hungry minds ready to murder me.
Hopefully, the only pet mind murdering you.
Stew. Ready?
No, what are you doing up here? It's potentially dangerous. I told you to lock your doors.
I thought I'd let you know that something's been stolen from my room.
Oh, not another theft. First a knife, then a knitting needle, then a rifle, and now what?
My laptop. I went to take it out of the case just now and it wasn't there. It's empty.
So it wasn't missing until you went back to your room?
Well, I don't know. I haven't used it since I arrived.
You know what this means?
What?
It could have been stolen hours ago. Any one of the guests could have it right now.
Okay, well, we'll keep an eye out for a missing laptop. But you should really return to your room.
Thanks.
The body's in the freezer. Any other lifting you need us to do?
I think that will be all fun, May. The two of you should return to your rooms now.
Well, this is certainly turning into quite the evening. This place isn't the calm bed and breakfast I was led to believe it was.
These murders certainly have put a bit of a damper on me, haven't they?
What the world?
Did the storm knock the tower out again?
The circuit breaker's in the mother room off the kitchen. She's fixing it now. There we go.
I fixed it. Someone must have overloaded the circuits. Well, Connie, come help me set the table.
Yes, Peter.
Stupid.
What is it?
Hopefully it's the bottom of the bathtub!
What's so weird about that? Don't most people bathe?
Yes, but you're not moving!
What in the world just happened?
power going on and off all evening. This is certainly going to affect my review.
Is everything all right?
I'm not sure. I think something may have happened to Stefan.
Looks like we found Nell's missing laptop. It was in the bathtub with Stefan. It must have fallen into the water.
Is Stefan all right?
He's dead. The laptop was plugged into the wall next to the bathtub. When it hit the water, a fuse must have blown, causing the blackout. Stefan was electrocuted.
Stefan didn't bring a laptop. I don't understand. Nell just reported her laptop missing to us. Whoever stole it must have thrown it into the bathtub knowing it would electrocute Stefan. Suzanne, tell us exactly what happened.
Well, when we went back to our room, Stefan told me he wanted to take a bubble bath. Both of us tend to help him relieve his tension. And I told him I didn't care what he did because I didn't want to see his lying, cheating face. Then I decided to give myself a facial because my skin was getting a little dry. Good skin is essential for afternoons. Then I laid down on the bed and put some cucumber slices in my eyes to get rid of dryness. And then there was a sizzle and a pop. I removed the cucumber slices from my eyes to see the look that the lights were out. I started to make my way towards the bathroom, but someone shoved past me and ran out of our room.
Did you see who it was?
No, darling, it was too dark. I called out to Stefan, but he didn't answer. When the lights came on a little later, I found the phone.
We found this note in the bathtub with Stefan. It's in that same creepy thing.
Let's see what it says. Has there ever been someone who made you so mad that the thought of him murdered would make you feel glad? I know that you think what I did was quite bad, and maybe it was, but I'm not feeling sad.
This murder is sure somewhat.
Who could have done this to Stefan?
Don't look at me. I can't even figure out who murdered Aunt Gretchen and Rachel.
Hold it! Rachel, let me introduce you to my friends. They're helping me help Freddy solve my murder.
Well, our murders. From the looks on everyone's face, it seems as if there's been another murder.
Has there been another murder?
Yes. Yes.
Who now?
Stefan.
Huh. No, not Stefan. Who is doing this? Who is murdering random guests at my bed and breakfast?
Me.
Yes, we're all related. Whoever's doing this must be targeting our family.
We have to let Freddy know. Don't be silly, we're dead. You can't hear us or see us.
Oh, Rachel, do you really think this Beetle Brain can do it all by himself? I've been helping him all night. I have an idea.
Thank you.
thing is, you will be out here alone. No one will be here to protect you.
I can protect myself. When you get back to the hallway, make sure everyone knows that you're going back to the room and that I'm out here alone.
All right. Well, good night, dear. I'll be sleeping in our room if you need me.
Sweet dreams, Sugar Bear! Now I just need to wait.
Who do you think is the murderer, ma'am?
That
Do you know who the murderer is?
Yeah, it's Rhonda May, because she's my sister.
Well, the two of you should your yappers and sit down. I don't want to miss a minute of this. This is better than anything that happens on daytime.
Sorry, we have a question.
It's awfully late, Mr. Franklin. I need my beauty sleep.
You sure do. Keep your trap shut. One more nasty remark about my sister, and it'll be the last nasty remark you ever make.
What are you going to do? Murder him?
Enough, everyone. We've had nothing but threats and accusations all evening, and it hasn't solved a thing.
I don't see what good any more questioning will do.
Instead of asking questions, I've decided we should do a role play.
What's role play? It's like acting.
No, there's something wrong with that.
In your opinion.
I'm just going to act like you didn't say that.
I'm afraid I won't be needing your assistance for this one, Suzanne. I'd like to have our line friends act out each murder.
Just a minute. As manager for Molly, Minnie, and Maddie, I'd like to know how they're going to be compensated for this performance.
Isn't it compensation enough knowing that they could help you catch a murderer and that it could keep you alive?
Sounds good to me. They're all yours.
I'd like Maddie to act as Aunt Gretchen in this first role play. Pretend you're walking down the hallway, minding your own business. Molly, you will play the murderer.
Prepare to plunder! I must admit, even I was pleasantly surprised.
The subtle nuances were magnificent.
It's now time for the second role play. This time, Maddie, you will play the murderer, and Minnie, you will play Rachel. Perhaps another role play will spark something new. This time, Minnie, you will play the murderer, and Molly, you will play Stefan in the bathtub. Don't forget to write the poems. Good. Now, Molly, you go back to playing the murderer, and Minnie, you will play Christine.
Sweetie pie.
Look at she.
A rope. Very interesting. So, Molly, is that how you plan to murder Christine? Don't act innocent here. It was you who murdered Aunt Gretchen, Rachel, and Stefan.
You have no idea! Hey, mine's are supposed to be seen and not heard. It's in your contract.
Save it. I'm being accused of murder here.
It all makes sense. Who would suspect a mime of murder? She certainly never made any verbal threats, and she seemed innocent enough.
Then how do you know it's Molly?
The poems.
Don't tell me you're some sort of handwriting analyst.
No, but I'm not colorblind. The poems are written in a very distinct orange ink. The same orange ink on Molly's glove.
That's just cake frosting from the desserts. You said so yourself.
That's what I thought at first, too. But then I realized there's no orange frosting on the cake. The orange ink on Molly's glove must be from a felt tip pen. The same felt tip pen used to write the poems.
You're not as dumb as you look, Freddy.
Thank you.
Now we just have one tiny problem. You're going to have to die! All of you! You know so much! Do you think I could let any of you live knowing I'm the one responsible for three deaths?
But if you murder all of us, you'll be responsible for even more deaths.
And who's going to tell on me?
She brings up a good point.
Why did you murder Aunt Gretchen?
And Rachel!
It's a bomb!
That's the one piece of the puzzle I haven't been able to figure out yet.
Maybe this will help you. Do you recognize me?
No.
That's exactly the problem. I'm your cousin, Molly!
Another relative?
Cousin Molly? You mean Aunt Henry? I didn't know you were in show business.
You didn't know me at all. Nobody ever took the time to know me.
Many years ago, back when I was only 4 or 5, Aunt Henrietta had a falling out with her 4 sisters. No one's spoken to or about her, her husband, or her daughter since. I haven't seen you since you were just
first one killed. I always knew she was one crazy Yankee.
Listen, princess, put that toy down. This isn't a comic book. It's real life.
Does that gun work? No, it's just a prop I purchased at a comic book convention. Like, it's still will beat you with it. And you expect to do that how? Like, bitch.
That looked easy enough.
I can't believe my life has been saved by Princess Gracie Gumdrop.
Kristen, are you alright?
I'm fine. Oh dear. What are we going to do with Molly?
Tie her up and put her in the kitchen. We'll stick one of the Michael sisters at each entrance to make sure she doesn't escape.
Good plan. Let's get to it, sister. There's some rope in the mud room.
Good. We'll use that to tie the scoundrel up. We can't thank you enough, Mr. Franklin, for saving our lives.
You're a Yankee, but you're a good Yankee. Just for this, all the exotic squirrel critters we live on this here island will be yours.
We'd be giving up a fortune,
but it's worth it.
The storm was exciting.
Yes, it should all be over soon. When the ferry comes tomorrow, we'll alert the authorities.
Maybe now we can finish our discussion.
Sure. And let's hope there is no one listening in this time.
Beatrice, do you have any more desserts? I've got two mine here. We could eat a house.
Right this way now. Follow me.
Stupid. Can I get anyone anything? I think we'll be fine here.
Good. In that case, I quit. This life doesn't mean it's too stressful for me. I'm going back to working in neuroscience.
You know, out of all the lousy hotels, inns, and bed and breakfasts I've been to, this place certainly provided the most interesting experience. Now that's something to mention in my review.
Gracie Gumdrop? Or Ms. Jacobs, is it? I can't thank you enough. You saved our lives.
No, Freddy. Don't thank me. It is you who restored order to our dimension. I'm here merely as a guardian, a watchful shepherd looking over the flock of innocence, destroying all that dares to cross the path of virtue. You are the one who gives us hope, who gives us faith, who reminds us that, although we all love to eat sweets, always be prevented, responsible for us when crossing.
Well, it's certainly been an interesting start to our honeymoon.
Yes,
Jacobs.
I've always found a person you get to want to be quite attractive.
Oh, brother. Really? I've always found knitting to be a fascinating hobby.
Maybe I can show you a few stitches.
Only if I can show you a few uniforms.
Sounds like a perfect match.
But first, Freddy, I'd like to thank you for all that you've done.
You're certainly welcome.
How about a little hugging?
Go on.
Ow! Something poked me.
Oh, that's where it went. Wasn't lost after all.
Well, it's been quite the evening.
Yes, and look at the wonderful family you married into. What's left of it, that is.
Thanks for all your help. Ready to solve this first murder case without you.
And we'd just like to say that we are...